I had the perfect life. I was 17, had loads of money, loads of friends. I was living the dream. That is, until the day my world came crashing down. The day I found out my parents were suing me for being too rich. But before I go on, make sure you like and subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on any more crazy stories. It all began when I was 16 years old and we went on our family vacation to the beach. This was an annual tradition in our family for as long as I could remember. We always went to the same place, ate at the same fish and chip restaurant. In fact, we did the same activities every year and I loved it. I was so excited the morning we were due to leave. I got up early and got my clothes packed in my little suitcase. Mom, Dad, and my little sister Emma all jumped into the car and we set off for the beach. It was a hot summer day and Dad played the music on the radio loudly. We all sang along, laughing when Dad messed up the words. As was our tradition, when we arrived at the motel, we ran in, threw our bags on the bed, and set off straight to the beachfront to play on the amusement machines. Emma headed straight to her favorite machine and I ran to mine. I was soon dropping coins into the slot and pulling the handle. I watched excitedly as the reels whirled round. I never really won much, but the fun of the game was what I was there for. "Come on, kids, it's time for dinner," shouted Mom. "Just one more go," I replied. I dropped the coin into the slot and watched the first reel stop. Jackpot lit up. I watched the second reel stop. Jackpot again. My heart was racing as I watched the last reel stop. Jackpot! Suddenly, alarm bells were sounding, bright lights were flashing, and people came running to watch as millions of coins came tumbling out of the machine. I couldn't believe my eyes. I looked towards Mom and Dad. Mom looked in shock as she watched Dad come over to help me. I was rich. I had bagged the jackpot. We rushed back to the motel. We had planned to go out for our usual fish and chips. "Not tonight, Mom," I said. "Tonight, we are going to eat lobster." That was the night my life changed for the better. I had never been a very popular kid. At school, I usually sat and ate my lunch alone. Nobody wanted me on the soccer team. I guess I was a bit of a loner. But all that changed when I got back from our holiday. When I got back to school, I suddenly had loads of friends. Even the cool kids asked me to hang out with them. The first thing I bought was a bright red shiny sports car. I had all this money now. I couldn't have my mom driving me around town. Only problem was, I couldn't drive. So I got a chauffeur. His name is John. Now John takes me everywhere I want to go. John wears a chauffeur uniform so everyone knows it's my car. One time, we were all hanging out at the mall. My new friends were looking at all the expensive sneakers. They couldn't afford them, but I could. I told the sales girl to get everyone a pair of the best sneakers and I would pay for them. All my friends loved me so much. I was so happy. "Let's go for a milkshake," I shouted. "It's my treat." We headed to our usual cafe and grabbed a booth. This was so much fun. We were all enjoying our milkshakes when suddenly a crash came from the kitchen. The waitress was crying. She had dropped her order and she was going to have to pay for all of it out of her salary. I ran over. "Don't cry," I said. "I'll pay for everything." I threw a wad of notes over to her. She looked at me and gave me a big smile. My heart skipped a beat. Now was my chance. "Would you like to go out on a date?" I stuttered. "Yes," she replied. I felt like dancing on the tables. I had my first date. Her name was Laura, and she was beautiful. I never dreamt a girl like her would want to go out with me. I took her to the movies. I bought her popcorn and candy and anything else she wanted. She was my dream girl. We soon began spending all our time together. I loved spending money on her. She needed a lot of new things when I met her. I took her shopping for dresses and shoes and handbags and jewelry. We wanted to go on holiday together, but I didn't want to drop all my friends that I had just made. I decided we would all go on holiday together. We could go on a cruise around the Caribbean. I had always wanted to go on a cruise ship. I booked the tickets and told all my friends. They were screaming with joy. My parents didn't look too happy when I told them our plans. Mom looked disappointed in me. Dad said he thought I should settle down a bit. I should think about putting my money away for college, but I was having too much fun, And anyway, it was my money and I could do whatever I wanted with it. We went on our cruise and had so much fun. We went swimming and dancing and there was so much food. When I got back home, there was a surprise waiting for me. I walked into the room and there, sitting with Mom and Dad, was a stranger, a woman looking very serious.
"Sit down, Kevin," said Dad. "We need to talk to you."
"This is Angela," said Mom. "She's going to talk to you about your overspending."
"What?" I screamed. "This has nothing to do with you. It's my money, and I can spend it however I like." I ran out of the house and jumped into my car. "Take me to Laura's house, please, John."
"What's wrong?" Laura asked when I got there.
"My parents are trying to stop me from spending my money," I replied. Laura looked aghast.
"What? They can't do that, can they?"
Laura looked a little worried. "Of course not," I replied. "Come on, let's go out for dinner," I said. The next day, I went down for breakfast. Mom was crying, and Dad looked really angry. "Kevin, you have left us no choice," Dad said as he handed me a big brown envelope. I opened the envelope and read the letter inside. I couldn't believe my eyes. My parents were suing me for being too rich. I had to go to court. "I hate you," I screamed. "You're ruining my life." I grabbed my bag and ran out of the house.
"Come back," pleaded Mom. "We're only doing this for your own good."
When I got to school, I told all my friends what my parents had done. They all agreed with me. My parents had no right to tell me what to do with my money. I needed to get a good defense lawyer. After all, I could afford the best money could buy. My lawyer told me there was no way I would lose this case. I laughed when I thought about our day in court. I would show my parents who was the boss. I decided I needed to do something really extravagant to celebrate. I was going to throw a huge party for all my friends. I booked an expensive hotel and sent out all the invitations. I wanted the best of everything. The room was decorated with balloons and glitter balls hung from the ceiling. My friends started to arrive and I was the perfect host. Everyone told me how amazing I was. Waitresses handed out drinks and an endless supply of the best food. I was having the time of my life. Nothing could go wrong. Suddenly, I heard a big commotion at the entrance. I looked over and saw my dad standing, arguing with the doorman. I had given instructions for them to not let Mom or Dad come in. I knew they would just want to stop me from having fun. I strode over to tell Dad he wasn't welcome when he suddenly noticed me and shouted, "Kevin, it's your mom. She's in the hospital." I ran to Dad. "What's happened?" "Come on, Kevin. I will tell you on the way to the hospital," said Dad. We jumped in Dad's car and drove as fast as we could to the hospital. On the way there, Dad explained that Mom had been so worried about me. She had heard about my party and said she was going to try to stop me. She had run out of the house and didn't see the car coming as she crossed the road. The car hit her and sent Mom flying through the air. We arrived at the hospital and ran to the emergency department. "Your wife is in surgery," the nurse explained to my dad. "Will she be okay?" I asked worriedly. "She's in the best hands," the nurse replied. We waited for what seemed like forever. Eventually, the doctor came out smiling and said, "Your wife is fine. You can go see her now." I ran to her room. Mom was sitting up in bed and looked so happy to see me. I felt bad that she had ended up in the hospital, but I still wasn't going to change my ways. I spent more and more time with my friends. I didn't want to be at home. I felt guilty when I looked at Mom and Dad. When I was out with my friends, we had so much fun. I loved my parents, but I'm ashamed to say, I loved my friends more. The day of the court case eventually came around. I got up in the morning, left the house without saying goodbye to my parents, and went to meet my lawyer. We walked up the steps of the courthouse. My lawyer was smiling. He looked confident. We walked into the courtroom. The judge glanced over at me. My dad was the first one to take the stand. He told the judge how I had been overspending my winnings. Mom was sitting at the side. As she looked over to me, a tear ran down her cheek. Then it was my turn. My lawyer whispered to me, "Just remember everything I told you to say. You've got this." I looked at the judge, looked at my mom, my dad, and Emma. I realized what I had to do. "I'm sorry," I shouted. "You are right. I've been so stupid. I promise I will stop my spending and save my money for my college education." My lawyer looked frantic. "What are you doing?" he screamed at me. But all I cared about was Mom and Dad. Mom was smiling now, and Dad gave me a big hug. I felt so happy. I knew I had done the right thing. We all left the courthouse together. From then on, I changed my ways. I stopped spending money on my friends. Laura wasn't very happy when I told her I couldn't take her shopping. Laura broke up with me. My friends didn't want to hang around me so much now. I wasn't sad. I now knew that they only liked me because I bought them things and took them to nice places. I sold my bright red sports car. I took the bus everywhere now. I'm now attending college. I don't have lots of friends, but I have a few real friends. That's all I need.